Hello and welcome. So the first function for today is the if function. It is a logical function wherein you give a particular logical operation and the logical operation gives an answer of true or a false. So if the value is true, you want to get a certain kind of an output. If the value is false, then you want to get a certain kind of an output. So for that, in that cases, we use the if function. So I am going to take a very easy example over here. I have written the entire syntax of the if function. So the very first the argument, these are the arguments. This is a function in which you give the arguments within the brackets. So the first argument is the logical operation which I need to perform. It can be any basic operation, like when you are equating two numbers or you are calculating greater than equal to and all those kind of stuffs, right? So any logical operation you want to perform, and if the answer is true, then whatever value you specify in the second argument will be your output. And if this value is false, then whatever you specify over here in your third argument, then you get this as your output. So value if true and value if false are the values which you'll get as an output depending on the answer of the logical operation. So let us take a very easy example. I have a small table with a few names, math marks, English marks, and I have age and gender. Now suppose I want name of those students whose math marks is greater than 75. So there is a difference between greater than and greater than equal to. I'm just considering over here greater than. That means this particular student, Meeta, who has got 75 will not be my output. Like I just want those students whose marks is greater than 75. So in that case, what we do, we'll write a very basic if statement. We'll start by writing if, and the very first is the logical test or the logical operation which you want to perform. So the logical operation which I want to perform is that the math marks, this particular cell value should be greater than 75, comma, then I specify the value if true which I want as my output. Now this value if true is within the brackets, which means that you can either use this argument or you can just simply skip this particular argument. If you skip this argument, then the output which you'll get will be true. So let me, just because we want the output as the student name, so we'll select the student name cell, so that if this cell is true, like this entire condition is true, then my output will be cell B6, which is Ayush. Otherwise I do not want anything, I just want blank space. So I'll just give a blank space, right? This is what I just want. Otherwise, what you could have also done is that instead of this, I want, in case of value if true, I want to write as pass, and if this condition is false, then I want an output as fail. So this can also be done, right? So here I am getting a pass because this satisfies my operation which is greater than 75, and once I drag this, you'll see I get fail for all those values which are less than 75. So this is how you can use your, very simply you can use your if statement. Similarly, in case I am taking one more example wherein I just want name of those students who are female. So I have gender in this last column, where for female I have F and where for male I have M. So in this case, if I start with writing my if statement, the logical test now should be that the gender cell should be equal to F. Now F is a character variable. So whenever you mention any character variable or a string, then you mention it within your quotations. So I am just mentioning it within my quotations because this is how you write your text or the character variables, character strings in any particular function. You always give it within the within the quotations, right? Whereas this is not the case over here because we were using a number 75. Moving on, this is a basic logical test which we have performed, that if this cell is equal to F, is equal to female, then I want a true value which is the name. So in my case of a true value, I just want the name. Instead, I do not want anything. If this is not the case, if it is not equal to female, then I just want a blank space to be there. So I'll just give two colons. Two colons signifies there is nothing between this. So I'll get a blank space. So this is how here I get a blank space, because it's not equal to female. So I just get a blank space. I'll drag this down, and wherever my condition satisfies, wherever this is equal to female, I will get the output as the name. So this is how you give very simple use of if statement. We also have nested if statements, which is there in my another video. So this was if statement. Moving on, the next function which we'll do is the count if function. So the count if function, in this function what happens is that you need to count certain cells on the basis of a certain criteria. So a simple count function will give you the count of cells. Suppose I'm just giving you a small example. If I need to count the number of cells which I have selected currently, so it gives me a count of 6. So what is it does is that it counts, and as you can see, it just had counted these cells, which is 6. It ignored age, because in case of count function, it only counts the numeric cells and the non-blank cells, basically non-blank numeric cells. So it will ignore all the cells which are blank. It will ignore all the cells where we have the character variable. Similarly, if you use the count a function will give you all the non-blank cells. It can be a string, it can be anything. So it gives you 7 because it counts age over here. This was the major difference between count and count a. Count a will count only the numeric non-blank cells. Count a will calculate or will give you the number of cells which are non-blank. It will not consider whether it's a numeric or whether it's a text, right? So moving on, we are practicing count if. So count if, it will count the number of cells on the basis of a certain criteria. So I've taken two examples over here. The very first example says that count the number of students with math marks greater than 75. So I need to count all the number of students whose marks was greater than, math marks was greater than 75. So my criteria is what? My criteria is math marks greater than 75. And what are the number of cells which I want to count from? This is the number of, this is the range where I want to count from. So count if function goes like this. The arguments are, the very first is criteria range, the range from where you need to count the number of cells. And then your criteria, which is over here, math marks greater than 75. So it's very simple. Let us start writing. Count if. So first we give the range. Now what is this range? I've mentioned it over here. It is criteria range. Wherever you give your criteria, that only range you have to select, right? So this is my criteria range where I'll give my criteria. Again, I'm specifying this because this is very important. If I say range, that means only the criteria range. The range wherein you will imply your all your criteria which you are mentioning over here in your second argument. Now, in the second argument, I need to mention the criteria is greater than 75. Now, this greater than 75 is not for specifically one cell. It is for all these cells. So, do I need to select any particular cell as I did in case of the if statement? No, I do not have to do this. What I'll do instead is I write it within the quotations. So I'll say within the quotations greater than 75. This is how I represent it. Why again? Because this greater than 75 is for all the cells within my criteria range. Like it will go for this. Each cell has to pass this criteria. So there is no specific cell over here for which I just have to mention greater than 75. It is for all the cells within my criteria range. So for that case, I need to mention it within the quotations to tell Excel that you are mentioning this criteria for all the separate cell individually in this particular range which you have. So let me just click on enter and see what happens. You get an answer of 4. So it's 1, 2, 3 and 4. These are the 4 students who got more than 75. Now in the same way, we'll learn something new, which is count ifs. Suppose you have more than one criteria to satisfy. Suppose I have one criteria is count the number of male students with math marks 75, greater than 75. So here you can see there are two criteria. First criteria is the student has to be a male. So the student has to be a male. Now in that case, the student also has to get a marks greater than 75. So the two conditions, with the student, which the student has to satisfy, is that it has to be a male, the student has to be a male, and the marks should be greater than 75. So for that case, we use count ifs, because we have more than one criteria to satisfy. So I'll write count ifs over here. And then we have the criteria range 1 and the criteria 1. So you can see we have criteria range 1, because here we can have many criteria, and for each criteria, as I said over here, you have different criteria range, right? So the very first criteria is, this is the criteria range where I'll put my criteria of being a male, comma. So being a male, I'll just give it in within the quotations. Again, I'm not explaining why I'm putting quotations. First of all, obviously it's a character, and also because you need to specify this criteria for all the cells within this range. So there is no need of giving an equal to sign over here, because it is obviously meant that it has to satisfy this entire M, right? The next criteria range over here is the math, the entire range. So I'll specify this range only, nothing else. I will not select the names range, because this is the range which I need to apply my criteria on. So in whatever range you want to apply your criteria on should be your criteria range. So this is my criteria range, and as you can see, this entire thing is present within the table, so there is no place of error, because you have this, you have no extra names, and you do not have any extra math marks. So you have it entirely within the table. Each student has a math marks and has a gender specified. So then it will just simply count your number of students. Also, you can make sure that your math marks, the criteria range selected over here and the criteria range selected over here should be equal, otherwise there will be a miscalculation. So this thing is very important to take the criteria ranges, all the criteria ranges equal, because otherwise you will not get a good answer. Your answer will be wrong. As you can see, I've taken 6 cells for the math criteria and I've taken 6 cells for the gender criteria. So in this cases, you always have to see as to your range which you have selected are equal in length, otherwise you will get a wrong answer. Right, now the criteria over here is that it should be again greater than 75, again mentioning it within the quotations. So I'll just click an equal to, and we have 2 males. For this male, you have marks 67, so does not satisfy this math marks criteria. So this is the student only who will satisfy both the criteria. So here it needs to specify, whatever criteria you specify, both the criteria needs to be satisfied in order to get the answer. So it works like of an AND function, you can say. If only both the criteria are satisfied, then only you will get an output, otherwise you won't. So in this case, you saw it satisfied the criteria of being a male, but then it did not satisfy the criteria of having math marks greater than 75. So it just satisfied one criteria, and hence we just got this as the answer. So this is how you use the count if function. I've showed you all four functions over here: count, count a, count if, and count ifs. So if you have more than one criteria, you can simply use count ifs. For single criteria, obviously, I can just simply use a count if. Moving on, the next function which we are going to learn is the VLOOKUP function. This is a very important function of Excel. In this, I've just taken a small table. When we have large size of table with us, it becomes really easier to use VLOOKUP and get the values whichever we want from a table. Now, suppose here I have mentioned name of few students and I want age of these students. I can just go up to the table and easily look out for Anush and the age is 17. I can just type it down over here as 17. Again for Sakshi, I can just look it over here. It is 16, so I can just type it down 16. But what if, imagine, you have 100 rows. If you have 100 rows, then it becomes so difficult for you to just trace the student's name, to trace the student's name and then to look up for the marks and then for the age and then to note down the age. It becomes really cumbersome. In those cases, we use the VLOOKUP functions, right? It becomes really simple. It makes your task very, very simple. And how it works? So I've written the entire syntax. Let us just not look up for this, look into this syntax, and let us just start with our demonstration so you all understand what it consists of. So we have VLOOKUP. VLOOKUP basically means vertical lookup. Now why we are saying vertical lookup? Because we are vertically looking the values. The values are within the columns, as you can see. So I'm looking up for Anush, which is within this column. And what I'm looking for is the age, which is again in a particular column. Suppose my entire table was in a horizontal manner. Suppose my name were in this particular row, then I had math marks, English, and then I had age. So in those cases, we use another alternative to VLOOKUP, which is an HLOOKUP, horizontal lookup. In those cases, what happens? Your data values are in row wise, not in column wise. Here we have our data column wise. So we are using VLOOKUP, which is vertical lookup. You are looking the values vertically from the columns. You are looking for values over here. First the name. So first I look up for the Anush. So I look up for Anush. Anush is here and then I will compare it with the column, this particular column which I'll specify in my syntax, and I'll get the value of 17. So as my lookup value is the value which you are first going to look for. You will not directly look up for the age, right? In the table, first I will look for the age as I was doing before. You will first look up for the age. So your lookup value, sorry, the first thing you will look up is the name. So when I was writing down the age manually, what I was doing was I was just seeing Anush. I was comparing it over here, Anush, and then I was taking out the age. So the very first thing which I was looking in my table was the name. So the name is my lookup value. So in case of lookup value, I will select Anush from here, comma. The table array is the array from where, the table from where you're extracting the values. And this is the table which from where I'm extracting my values. So I'll just select this entire table. Now you need to make sure one thing over here, which is in case of the table array, when you select your table array, always and always make sure that your lookup value, that your lookup value column should be on the leftmost of the table. So over here we have this as my lookup value column. This is the column from which I will look up for my values, Anush, Sakshi, Meeta, and all those. So this is the column from wherein I will look up for my values first. So this column should always be on the leftmost of the table which you select. So here comes in the disadvantage of VLOOKUP. The disadvantage of using VLOOKUP sometimes is that what if my name column was to the right of the age column? That means my entire table started with age and then I had name. So in that case, whenever you select the table, in that case it is not possible to select your table with the name column being the leftmost column. So this is the place wherein your disadvantage of VLOOKUP sets in, is that the lookup value column should be always on the left, and if it is on the right, then you will not get your answer. So it should always be on the leftmost. This is the place where you get the disadvantage of VLOOKUP. To overcome that, we use index match functions. Now the column index, so let me do one thing. Let me make this table array constant, because my table array is not changing. It will always remain the same. right? So I will click on F4 to make it constant. I will click on F4 to make it constant or absolute, basically, so that whenever I drag my lookup function, VLOOKUP function, B4 and F10 should not change. Now we have column index number. This is the column index, this is the column number from where I need to extract my value. So when I was looking for Anush, I was first looking for the name Anush over here. The next thing I was looking up for the column in which I have age. So it was in fourth column, and then I was getting the age, which is 17. So in this table which you have selected, again I'm repeating, the table which you have selected, in that table, in this table, what is the column index number, what is the column number from wherein you have to extract the value of age? So it is 1, 2, 3, 4. Fourth column, it is from the fourth column is that I want to extract my values. So I will type in 4 over here. And then this is a very important thing to consider, the lookup, the range lookup. Now what is range lookup? There is something called true and false. False is the exact match, true is the approximate match, meaning that there are sometimes names where you have similar kind of names, or maybe your lookup values sometimes turns out to be very similar. Like over here we have Ayush and we have Anush, kind of similar, just a difference of Y and an N. So this difference, sometimes what happens when you have lots and lots of data and when you give an approximate match, so even for Ayush you may get an answer which is for Anush. So it might so happen for the age of Anush you will get an 18 and not 17. So it might so happen when you have large sets of values. So over here we need an exact match only for Anush, not for Ayush. So I will go with false. I will just double click on false and I will close the bracket. So what I'm doing is, this is my lookup value, the value which I first look for in my table. So I selected this value, then the entire table. Always remember that the lookup value, whatever the lookup value you select, that column should always be on the leftmost, and then the column index number from wherein you need to extract your value. So I have taken 4 and then false, so it will give me 17. As you can see, the answer is 17. So I will just simply drag this down. Also, if I would have specified instead of 4, I would have specified 2, then I would have got math marks. 3, I would have got English, and 5, I would have got the gender. Now you can see, you can match the answer for year. The answer is 16 and the answer is 16. So it doesn't matter in what order your names are. Even if you change the name over here, suppose I change it to Priya, let me just change it and see, it changed to 19. So this is how interesting and useful VLOOKUP function is. Generally we use for very large data sets, and also suppose we have a table here and we want to get the lookup answer in some other sheet, then also we can do that. We can do the same thing. You need to just do, you can just write the same syntax, the same function in the different sheet, and then get the answer. Thank you. This is it for this video.